Good evening and welcome to the Green Room 42. Thank you so much for being here. At this time, we ask you please take a moment, silence your phones. At the Green Room 42, the use of photography and recording is strictly encouraged. And please tag us in your pictures and your videos at the Green Room 42. If you need to use the restroom, please exit through the doors you came in through. They're located down the hall on the other side of the elevators. And if you'd like to order something during the performance, our servers will be available throughout the duration of the show, or you can use the table number on your lamp to order online. With those few necessities out of the way, I want you to please put your hands together for the reason you're all here, Reeve Carney.
Thank you very much. Thanks so much, you guys. You guys missed the Oscars for this, too. Thank you. We're DVRing them also. I don't know if you guys are. Thank you. Thanks so much. So I hope that no one's surprised by the fact that, I tend to play primarily original material at these shows, but this was advertised as something different, which is what it will be. So tonight I'll be doing a concert full of songs traditionally and historically performed by some of my favorite Broadway divas, but that's in a good way, you know, I mean that in a positive way. And I hope they're some of your favorites too.
Here's to the ladies who lunch, everybody laughs, lounging in their caftans and planning a brunch on their own behalf. Off to the gym, then to a fitting, claiming their fat and looking grim, 'cause they've been sitting choosing a hat. Does anyone still wear a hat? I do. I'll drink to that. Stay smart, aren't they aghast? Rushing to their classes in optical art, wishing it would pass. Another long, exhausting day, another $1,000. A matinee, a pen to play, perhaps a piece of Mylar's. I'll drink to that. Then one for Mother. Now here's the girls who play wife, aren't they too much? Keeping house but clutching a copy of Life just to keep in touch. The ones who follow the rules and meet themselves at the schools, too busy to know that they're fools. Aren't they a gem? Just watch, aren't they the best? When they get depressed. It's a bottle of scotch plus a little chest.
Do Sondheim like that. I'm gonna go back to that verse.
Here's the girls who just watch. Aren't they the best? When they get depressed, it's a bottle of scotch plus a little chest. Another chance to disapprove. Another brilliant singer. Another reason not to move. Another vodka stinger. Drink to that. So here's the girls on the go. Everybody tries. Look into their eyes and you'll see what they know. Everybody dies. The dinosaur surviving the crunch. Let's cheer it for the ladies who lunch. Everybody rise,
Thanks so much for that warm reception. Really, it really helps encourage me onward. I appreciate that. I don't mind those little interjections. Thank you to whoever was doing that. Especially since there's only one of me up here, so it feels like, you know, it's nice. So I really in the process of putting together this set, I really fell in love, not in a romantic sense, but with Elaine Stritch. I mean, obviously, I'm not falling in love with anybody except the one who's... But you know what I mean. Incredible performer. Well, but at the moment, I'm talking about Elaine Stritch. And yeah.
Wow.
You gotta watch the PBS one where it's just her with a black background. That's so cool. This actually might be, of all the songs in the set tonight, this may be the first one I ever heard. I think I saw this film when I was probably about 3 years old.
Raindrops and roses and whiskers on kittens. Bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens. Brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels. Doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles. Wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses and blue satin sashes. Snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes. Silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings. When I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things. And then I don't feel so strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels. Doorbells and sleigh bells.
Oh, thank you. Thanks so much. It's the thick water. Been a while. Thank you. Okay. So this one, this song only qualified because, although technically you might say Devo, I think it works either way. And I hadn't thought to do this song until I heard Billy Porter's version. So yeah. This is kind of based on his.
Your story's sad to tell, a teenage ne'er-do-well, most mixed up non-delinquent on the block. Your future's so unclear now, what's left of your career now? Can't even get a trade-in on your smile. Beauty school dropout, no graduation day for you. Beauty school dropout, miss your midterms and flux shampoo. Well, at least you could have taken time to wash and clean your clothes up after spending all that dough to have the doctor fix your nose up. Baby, get moving. Why keep your feeble hopes alive? What are you proving? Got the dream, but not the drive. You can go for your diploma, and you join the steno pool, turn in your T's and comb, and go back to high school. Beauty school dropout, hanging around the corner store. Beauty school dropout, it's about time you knew the score. Well, they couldn't teach you anything. You think you're such a looker, but no customer would go to you unless you were a hooker. Woo, baby, don't sweat it. You're not cut out to hold a job. Baby, forget it. Who wants their hair done by a slob? And your lashes curl, your bangs twirl, and still you. Turn in your cheese and comb and go back to high school. Baby, don't blow it. Don't put my good advice to shame. Baby, you know it. Even the rabbits say the same. Well, I've called the shot. Get off the pot. I've really gotta fly. Got to be going to that mug shop in the sky. Beauty school dropout, go back to high school. Beauty school dropout, go back to high school. Beauty school dropout, go back to high school.
Thank you. So I'm embarrassed to say that this next song I had never heard. I don't know how. I haven't seen the show live yet. I guess that's how. But when I was putting the set together, I asked for Eva's opinion on a lot of things, and this song was a recommendation by Eva, so you can thank her, because it's a great song. I'll do my best on it. Well, actually, you know what? I don't know why I'm not telling more stories yet, but I don't have much of a connection to the great Bernadette Peters, so I won't tell you what song. I guess I'll still surprise you because you don't know what song it is yet, but I was thinking, should I say it or not? But other than Broadway Barks, and it was a little embarrassing because that was the first thing I said to her when we sat next to her down the row from her at the Music Man Actors Fund performance. I was like, no, it's fine. She was very nice, but it's just funny, like, as opposed to anything else I could have said. I'm so sorry I didn't make it to Broadway Barks this year, which I did. I did want to go. Maybe that was the right thing to say. I don't know. So this is a beautiful song. I hope you enjoy.
Just being kind.
Thank you. Thank you. I've only done this show, technically this is the fourth time I've done it, because these amazing people in Detroit saw me here at Greenman 42 3 years ago or more, and booked me at a place called Cabaret 313 in Detroit. And they said that their clientele doesn't normally really respond to original music that they haven't heard, so, which you guys are amazing. How many of you have never seen me in this setting before? So that, thank you guys for coming. Because I know a lot of you have, and I appreciate you guys coming, because you guys don't, thankfully you don't mind the original music, but this gave me a new thing to try out, because I'd never thought of, thank you, I never thought of a whole set like this, but it keeps it fun for me too. So, but this next song, I have the sort of distinct honor of, I might be, I don't know, maybe not, I might be one of the only men that shared a dressing room with Patti LuPone. I don't know, is that possible? I know, right? Technically, there was no dressing going on at the same time, so it was. But I was on a TV show called Penny Dreadful, which some of you know, yeah. And in season two, our schedules were, they didn't have enough rooms to have everyone have an amazing room, so we had a totally different schedule, so we were never there at the same time, really. So we shared a room, which is cool. But this next song is from, it's the title song from one of her incredible roles. It's funny how it always feels relevant, this song, you know? I think that's just the way the world works, which is cool.
Times have changed. We've often rewound the clock since the Puritans got a shock when they landed on Plymouth Rock. If today any shock they should try to stem instead of landing on Plymouth Rock, Plymouth Rock would land on them. Was looked on as something shocking, but now God knows anything goes. Good authors too, who once used better words, now only use for better words, writing prose. Anything goes. The world has gone mad today, and good's bad today, and black's white today, and day's night today, when most guys today, the women prize today are just silly gigolos. In other words, it knows better. No moments on your mind, the one over there. Anything goes. Boo boo, da da da, with the one, da da da, ba ba da da da, ba 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 da. Silly gigolos. And though I'm not a great romancer, I know that I'm about to answer when you propose. Anything goes. When grandmama, whose age is 80, and nightclubs is getting matey with gigolos. Anything goes. When mother's back to leave poor father, because they decide they'd rather be tennis pros. Anything goes. If driving fast cars, you like it low bars, you like it old hymns, you like it bare lips, you like it Mae West, you like on me undressed, you like when nobody will oppose. And every night the set the spot is intruding and nudist parties in the studios. Anything goes. When nobody will oppose. And every night the set the spot is intruding and nudist parties in studios. Anything goes. Anything goes. Anything goes. Anything goes. Anything goes.
Thank you. That one's a wordy one. Sorry for some of the verbal errors. Thank you guys so much. Thanks. There's an orchestral section of that that one day I'm going to learn. It's just, I didn't have time this time around. It's a whole thing. But, yes. So, I went to a performing arts academy for high school. I guess there are enough new people here that you might, no one's heard any of this stuff, so this is great. I mean, not that I say it the same every time, I hope. But, I remember, to this day, I'm working on it now, but being terrified of these this particular chord progression. And it actually originated with this cover that I'm going to do tonight. Those changes are known as rhythm changes. Have you heard of those?
Yeah.
Kind of terrifying to solo over at high speed. I couldn't leave Ethel Merman out of the mix, you know?
Yeah.
So. Although I do have a microphone tonight, so I don't know if that's cheating.
Days can be sunny with never a sign. Don't need what money can't buy. Birds in the trees sing their days full of song. Why shouldn't we sing along? I'm chipper all the day, happy with my life. Do I get that way? Look at what I've got. I've got rhythm, I've got music, I've got my gal. Who could ask for anything more? I've got daisies in green pastures. I've got my gal. Who could ask for anything more? Old man Trouble, I don't mind him. You won't find him running around my door. I've got starlight, sweet dreams. I've got my gal. Who could ask for anything more? Who could ask for anything more? Whoa.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, you guys. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. So, I meant to Google this and forgot to do that. Am I correct in my assumption that Dame Shirley Bassey has not appeared on Broadway, or is that totally ignorant of me?
Correct.
Okay, thank goodness. I was like, but she still fits, so. Water has more calories, but yeah, it is pretty hot. Yeah, thankfully, because there are a good amount of you guys, so it keeps this place warm. Okay, thanks. Goldfinger, he's the man with the mightiest touch, a spider's touch, such a cold finger beckons you to enter his web of sin. But don't go in. Golden words he will pour into your ear, but his lies can't disguise what you fear. For the golden girl lies when he's kissed her. It's the kiss of death from Mr. Goldfinger. Pretty girl, beware. Thank you guys so much. I want to thank Sharon in the back for mixing this to sound, all the little stylistic tweaks. Thank you. Okay. We've been working together a long time now. It's kind of crazy. It's been probably done like 20 of these shows now. Not this exact show, but. Speaking of which, if you guys are not just visitors, I will be back here on April 23rd playing my own music. So if you'd like to come back, come on back. I'll be here. Yeah, sorry. Or live stream, too. Okay. Hey, hello to the live stream. It's great, because like, I think it's perfect, because I think the view is really great at home. I've seen it. And they used to have cameras on stage, but I think this probably is a better thing, because then you guys don't see it either. You would have no idea, would you, right? So, I mentioned before that I went to Performing Arts Academy. It was pretty big. I mean, I don't know if you guys have heard of it, but it's, when I was going to, it was called Hamilton Academy of Music at Hamilton High School, which actually, I never mentioned this, but do you know another famous, there are actually a lot of really well-known alumni, yeah. There are a lot of famous alumni at, yeah, what is this Latin stuff, this new Latin? Famous alumni, and including Joel Grey. We went to the same high school. So, I didn't actually perform in any of the musicals. My teacher, I had been acting a little bit as a kid, and my musical theater teacher, I took intro to musical theater in ninth grade, and he knew, I think it's partially because he knew that I had done a film called Snow Falling on Cedars. Have you guys seen that ever? But that was my first, like, kind of big-ish role, I guess, as a kid actor. And then I quit right after that. Like, I'd wanted to be an actor since I was 8 years old. And it felt like it took so long to get a job, which I guess 6 years to a 14-year-old is kind of a long time. But when I got that job, and I pretty much quit immediately after for, like, the next 12 years. But my musical theater teacher had seen that, and I think is why, and he thought I'd be someone who should audition. They were doing Bye Bye Birdie next, and so he said, "You know, you play guitar, you know, and you should audition to play Conrad." And I didn't. I didn't want to do that. I at the time, I didn't really want to be on stage acting. Because it was a time when I'm not going to name any names, but there were a lot of musicians that were transitioning to acting, and no one took them seriously at all. So I didn't think, it seemed like you kind of had to choose one or the other. And so for that reason, I chose music. But my teacher tried to get me into that. I was in the jazz band, and so I did end up playing in the orchestra pit for Bye Bye Birdie. And this show just immediately preceding Bye Bye Birdie was a show called Damn Yankees. And oddly enough, in a very roundabout sort of way, Damn Yankees is what led me to fall in love with Sarah Vaughan's music. Next song, and my version is based on hers.
Whatever Lola wants, Lola gets, and a little man. Little Lola wants you. Make up your mind to have no regrets. Recline yourself, resign yourself, you're through. She always gets what she aims for. And your heart and soul is what she came for. Whatever Lola wants, Lola gets. Take off your coat, don't you know you can't win? You're no exception to the rule. She's irresistible, you fool. Give him. Thank you. she aims for, and your heart and soul is what she came for. Whatever Lola wants, Lola gets. Take off your coat, don't you know you can't win? You're no exception to the rule. She's irresistible, you fool. Give in, give in, you'll never win. Give in, give in, you'll never win. Give in, give in, you'll never win. Give in, give in, you'll never win.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And so this next song is probably the first one that I performed in this set. Of this set, this is the first one I performed probably for the first time maybe 10 years ago at a place called Rockwood Music Hall. I've always been a fan of this performer and her whole family.
Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far. behind me. Oh, where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you
very much. Thank you guys. Thank you guys for willing to be coming out and stay out this late. I so appreciate it. I know it's late, and I was hoping not too late for you, but thank you so much. Is it good? Oh, yeah, I've been accused of being a vampire myself, but I promise I don't bite anybody. And wait, I was going to make another joke, but I probably shouldn't. Oh, boy. So in addition, I had this really amazing, I hope you don't mind, and I hope I do keep them a little fresh for those of you who are kind enough to come see me so often. But for those of you who have never, I've got to fill you in on some of this information. Pretty amazing. Thanks to my mom, I had this incredible opportunity of education, I guess you'd call it, because I went to a performing arts high school, which was a magnet program that we were bussed in from like 45 minutes. Well, it depends where you live, but it was like a 45-minute bus ride each way to get there. So I'd have to get up at 6 a.m. to go to school. But for financial reasons, my parents were going through divorce. They don't mind me saying this, I don't think, but they were going through divorce when I was 14, and so there wasn't that much money for guitar lessons and stuff like that. So my mom had an idea to start taking me to blues clubs, which is so crazy and awesome, because like there were two blues clubs, actually three, in our neighborhood. But back then, there was sort of a blues explosion in the 90s. Do you guys remember this at all? I mean, it was like not like the British Invasion blues explosion or any of that stuff, but or like the you know, the Yardbirds era stuff. It wasn't quite as extreme as that in the 60s, but there was this kind of huge group of young kind of teenage guitar players that were coming out. Johnny Lang, who's a dear friend of mine, Kenny Wayne Shepherd, if you know these names, Monster Mike Welch, who is now a dear friend of mine, and so many, Sean Costello. Rest in peace, you incredible guitar player. But yeah, there were just a lot of these, and so there were. I think that's why there were so many blues clubs in our area, which was great for me because we would go there, and because I was with my mom, they let me sit there for like 3 hours and just absorb whatever I could from all these masters playing on stage, and then they would let me sit in after like I think even like the second time I went there, they let me sit in and they start with something kind of easy. And you just learn so much that way. But then, I get home at probably 1:30 and then wake up again for school the next day. But it was great because I had heard that another one of my heroes, Stevie Ray Vaughan, did that. I remember this documentary where he talked about doing a similar thing. So I was like, yeah, I'll follow in the path in terms of the education part, you know. But yes. So this next song is sort of a twist on. Thankfully, they finally. She's the first recipient of this incredible honor. Now at the Lena Horne Theater, this next song is based on the Lena Horne version, but it's going to be probably a little more bluesy because I figured that's why I'm talking about this. You know, the reason I brought that up really is my uncle is an incredible blues guitar player, and he introduced me to this song when I was 15. Okay, yeah, actually. Thank you. I do have a couple more, and I thought I was moving over there. I'm going to play a little bit over there, but I have one more thing here. And then, thank you. Thank you. Thanks so much. This might be one of my favorites. And Eva and I had a Christmas of getting each other like gifts in exactly the same theme, which was so cool. We started watching we didn't know what the other one was gonna be. But we only recently watched Fosse Verdon. Have you guys seen that?
Yeah.
And there's a connection there. Well, Liza's appearance in Fosse Verdon is the connection, but I grew certainly a deeper love for Gwen Verdon and Bob Fosse through watching that. And this is a song that you'll certainly recognize, I think, if you're a musical theater fan. And actually, I actually got Eva a Liza autograph that was from England. It's not to Eva, but maybe we can meet her and make it to Eva. Someone was selling it, so.
Maybe this time I'll be lucky. Maybe this time he'll stay. Maybe this time, for the first time, love won't hurry away. Anymore, like the last time and the time before. Everybody loves a winner, so nobody loved me. Lady Peaceful, that's what I long to be. Well, all the odds are there in my favor. Something's bound to begin. It's gotta happen. It happens sometime. Maybe this time I will. Everybody loves a winner, so nobody loves me. Lady Peaceful, Lady Happy, that's what I long to be. Well, all the odds are there in my favor. Something's bound to begin.
Oh, Thank you. So if you guys don't mind, I figured I'd play one original song for you, just so you know. And the reason being that this might be, I don't know, I love the musical theater idiom. I love it all, but I tend to really gravitate towards some of the older stuff. And this song is certainly inspired by that era. And it's on an album of mine. If you have Spotify or Apple or all that stuff, it's the album's called Youth Is Wasted. But this is that song. Thanks. But yeah, I hope you enjoy it. Much. Thank you. I want to thank those of you who stayed from Eva's mind-bending, mind-blowing show. I want to give another hand to Eva Noblezada, who keeps like blowing my mind, even though I hear her every day and see her. It's incredible. But yeah, okay, so I've only got a couple more. I thank you guys so much for being here. I hope I'm not overstaying my welcome. It feels, yeah. But Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you. I won't be too much longer. This one is, again, not technically a Broadway diva, maybe, but the composer of this song is now Broadway royalty because of her show Beautiful. And so I was just astonished when I saw this performer sing this song at the Kennedy Center Honors. Did you watch Aretha's performance on that? Oh, man. If you after when you go home, watch Aretha Franklin's Kennedy Center Honors performance of this song that I'm going to try to do my best on. But I love this song, and I thought it'd be interesting since, you know, yeah. Someone like me might not normally sing it, you know, because of the lyrics, but you know what? It's okay. Thank you guys again for being such an amazing audience. I really appreciate your warmth. Thank you. And we can all watch the Oscars later if you DVR'd it. Hope.
Looking out at the morning rain, I used to feel so uninspired. When I thought I had to face another day, Lord, it made me feel so tired. For the day I met you, life was so unkind. You're the key to my peace of mind. 'Cause you make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman. Yeah. When my soul was in a lost and found, you came along, claim it. I didn't notice what was wrong with me until your kiss helped me name it. I'm no longer doubtful of what I'm living for. And if I make you happy, I don't need more. 'Cause you make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman. Oh, oh, what you done to me? Oh, you make me feel so good inside. I just wanna be so close to you. You make me feel alive. You make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman. Oh, make me feel, you make me feel, oh, then you make me feel like a natural woman.
Amazing, Aretha. That's one of those songs. That's actually the only one where I changed the key. I had to lower that one because it was like. She is just insane. But it's got that note's kind of right in the spot where I'm like, should I do it full? Should I back? I like it better when it's backed off, but I kind of messed that up. But that's okay. Thank you for listening. But I don't mean the whole song. I enjoyed it, but you know what I'm talking about. Thank you guys, though. I've always known this song. I've seen it live in a number of productions, but it was there's something about Angela Lansbury's version that really, really opens up a new understanding of the song. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to communicate what she communicates, but it made me really love the song. I've got just this song and one more on the piano, and I thank you guys so much for being here.
A dream about you, baby. It's gonna come true, baby. They think that we're through, but baby, you'll be swell, you'll be great. Gonna have the whole world on a plate. Starting here, starting now, honey, everything's coming up roses. Clear the deck, clear the track. You've got nothing to do but relax. Blow a kiss, take a bow, honey, everything's coming up roses. Now's your ending. Stand the world on its feet. Set it spinning. That'll be just the beginning. Curtain up, light the lights. You've got nothing to hit but the heights. I can tell you'll be great. I can tell, just you wait. That lucky star I talk about is you.
I'm going to go over here and end with a palate cleanser. Thank you so much. Yeah, I really appreciate you guys. So I want to do this set again sometime here, but I don't know when yet. But I will be back on the 23rd of April if you're in town. Thank you so much. So this one, I was listening to nonstop sort of just Broadway playlist just to pick which songs that really spoke to me, and I discovered a singer, an absolutely incredible singer named Marisha Wallace. Any of you know her? And I'd never heard this song sung like that before, so I'm gonna do my best to pay tribute to her version. Thank you all again, and I hope to see you soon. Also feels like a good one to end with, in a way. I don't know.
peace and quiet and open air. Wait for us somewhere.
So much. Thank you for being here.